But then, the real question is, Mandon, do you want to be hurt?
I don't want to be hurt. Nobody wants to be hurt.
Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Ask ZULA, and today's guest is Mandon.
Hello, I'm Mandon, I'm from TSL, I work as a content strategist, and I'm 26 this year.
So today's episode is to talk about relationships.
Okay.
And I think it's pertaining to your own story, right? It's the fact that you have not been in a very serious relationship for 26 years of your life. But it's nothing wrong with that, nothing wrong with that. It's just share a little bit more about your experience, lah.
Okay.
I think a lot of people in the comments always ask, like, wow, Mandon, like, how is Mandon still single? I read a lot of comments, you know, how is Mandon still single? Why Mandon, like, no girlfriend, why, or no partner, all this kind of thing. Yeah, so today, we are answering that question for you guys.
I feel very stressed, isn't
it? Why are you stressed?
Like, oh my goodness, why am I actually still single at 26?
I mean, that's my first question, basically. Do you have any particular reason or explanation as to why you haven't really been in a committed serious relationship for your life? Okay, on the disclaimer also, I feel like this episode got a lot of disclaimers. I don't think it's a bad thing. I just think it's an experience that at your age, most people or people that I know in my circle, like, have all been in a kind of a relationship before. Yeah. But I think you haven't, so maybe you can share.
What if I just say I don't believe in love?
Oh, the episode will end right now. Okay, thank you for watching this episode of Ask ZULA. Goodbye. Okay, stop avoiding the question, Mandon. Come on, give me your answer, give me your answer.
I think got quite a lot of factors there when it comes to play. Like, the first one is the fact that why would I want to get into a relationship?
Okay. Right?
Or like rather, why would people get into a relationship?
Right.
And then that's a very popular thing that people are saying these days, lah. Like, hey, why not just let girl chill, what? And then you also quite handsome, what? Then just get together with the girl. Then that'll be like, then for what?
Okay.
Just because like a person is eligible doesn't mean that the person should be in a relationship, correct?
Fair.
So like the baseline question I always ask myself, right? It's like, what is a relationship for?
Okay.
And then a lot of times that when I observe Singaporeans, especially, right? There are a lot of times, right, whereby you get in a relationship because you want to fulfill certain needs for yourself.
Of course.
Like companionship, like attention, or like people who are a bit more negative, or people with some experiences that are not as nice, they want affirmation, they want validation, that sort of thing, correct?
Fair.
But then again, when you go inside a relationship, expecting all those things to be given to you, it's very scary, because in the long run, that same person might change, you might change. Then it becomes very uncertain, you know?
Okay.
Like, if it's everything about you, and you going inside the relationship and thinking that, okay, I want all these things for my partner, and maybe like I can give you more of these things, when you think about yourself more than another person in a relationship, it becomes very, and in the long run, if the person cannot fulfill your needs anymore, then how?
Right, okay. Like, why did you project it so far into the future when you haven't even stepped into like a, never try, you know what I mean? Why you never try in the first place?
Because there's no need to actually try to know whether it will turn out well or not. It's like you smell tapian, and then you know tapian not nice already, then you're going to try to eat tapian for it.
Okay, I'm going to equivalent to like someone that you want to date as tapian, okay? Okay, I understand what you're trying to say. So in that sense, it's kind of like you are unsure of how it will proceed in the long run. Is that why you don't want to take the step?
Yeah, and like the whole thing about being committed in a relationship is that unlike a lot of things that you do in your own free time, whether people smoke, they go party, they get like pieces drunk and then they collapse in front of their house, that kind of.
Is that something you can relate to? Is that something you can relate to what you
said? No. So all these things, those things only like sick to, if there are any hurts, is you won't self kena only.
Right.
And then you just stay at home and then you cry for like 2 months and okay, you'll be okay with it. When you're in a relationship, any hurts that you cause, goes two ways on it.
Fair.
And if I choose to do this thing just because of I feel like doing it and like I just want to get a relationship just to like get the thrill of it, right? Then because you're unfair to the other person, should one day I hurt that person.
Understand. Okay.
So I don't want to bring this kind of responsibility on myself.
Yeah.
And to another person who probably don't know that I'm not ready for a relationship yet.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Because in those two ways, right, that would just generate more hurt in the long run. I don't think that's very fair, to anyone who's in that position.
So are you currently looking to be in a relationship with someone, or are you just telling me now that you are not gonna ever be ready for a relationship?
So the scary thing is that I don't know when I will be ready for a relationship.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because as I grow older lah, and I realize that there are a lot of flaws that I have. More okay. than the, I can cook, stay at home, all those things, right?
People
like all those things, but I think there are more layers to that.
Yeah,
about myself that I grow to not like and I want to be better at before committing to a relationship and hopefully a lifelong one lah. So that you won't get the whole breakup and then like both parties feel hurt, then you try to like, I don't know, get another relationship to fulfill certain needs again, then a bit tedious for me.
Understand.
A bit unnecessary for me.
Understand.
And unnecessary hurt to cause someone else lah,
okay.
if I am not happy with myself yet.
I feel that it's a very mature thinking, because I think like when people are, like what you mentioned, when people are young, when they want to get into relationships, always about two people wanting like something from each other, right? Like companionship is one of the biggest things, I guess, in a relationship. Yeah, so it's a human need, but you seem to not have this very strong human need for that, which is amazing, because I think that a lot of people, 90% of humans, crave this affection from another party. Yeah, be it whatever gender, whatever human it is. Yeah,
get a cat.
Fair, he has a cat.
Have you seen my cat, guys?
Okay, I mean a cat. Your cat is good. Are you gonna be not a crazy cat lady, but a crazy cat man in the future?
You know, recently.
Yeah.
Someone was talking to me about my relationship and all.
Uh-huh.
And I said, "Madam, why are you not attached?" Then I'm like, "No, I have a cat now. I'm happy where I am now, right?"
Mm.
Then the person just said, "But a cat can't suck." Really.
Oh, that's true.
Then I laugh and then I'm like, "Nah."
Okay, clearly that's not important to him, but yeah. I guess now you can understand a little bit about why you haven't chosen to get into a relationship, right? What are like the comments from people who... I mean, okay, YouTube comments is one thing, you know what I mean? Because people don't really know you in person. But for people like your friends around you, people in the office and stuff like that, then people hear this, right? What is their usual, typical response?
They don't believe me yet. They'll be like, huh? Secondary school don't have man. Primary school no crush man. They never gonna confess to people man.
Yeah.
Answer is, have.
Have.
But then at the end of that pursuit, right, I don't see the point of it. Because getting a relationship at that age didn't make sense to me then. And it don't even make sense to me now. Like imagine 16 years old trying to get attached and then no financial capability. You want to think long term, you also don't know how far. Your longest term is after poly, I go to NS. That's like think really. So if you want to talk about like relationships, for me, I think that it should last a lifetime until I die at age 30 lah. So
age 30 you're gonna die? That's like 4 years from now, Amanda. What are you talking about? Better get into a relationship faster. Only gonna last 4 years.
Yeah. Okay. So exactly lah. So
okay.
To avoid all those things, I would see those pursuits that I have last time as why bring myself through all those struggles.
Okay. Would you like to share your pursuits with the audience?
Okay.
Yay! Spilling some tea. Okay. Tell me.
Secondary school.
Yes.
There's this girl that I liked before.
Okay.
We talk like every day that kind.
Oh, okay.
Like at night, every text and all. Valentine's Day buy flower that kind. Buy chocolate.
Oh.
It's like old school lah, like old school. Okay. Then my friends will tell me, hey, man, just go to school early, yeah. You go and put the flower on the table.
Okay.
Then like nobody will know that kind.
Yeah.
I did that lah, but then the flower got water and then the whole table got water. I didn't know. See that? That's why I think that no man, 14-year-old Mandon should not get into a relationship.
Okay, bro, the girl doesn't care whether the water is on the table or not. If I see the flower there, I don't care whether my table is soaked in water. But oh my god, the flower!
Apparently she did, because the, you know the flower wrapper is made of paper, like those paper plastic that kind.
Yes.
Everything comes. So you put up, right? It's a wet mess.
Oh my god. Okay, Mandon.
So like on and off we talk and all. But then she got together with another guy.
Do you get scarred from that or something? That's why you're like, okay, I never want to be in a relationship again.
No, actually I was quite true with that. Because I had the boys to fall back on, then we just play Dota every day.
Okay.
Find yourself a group of guys. Find yourself a group of guys that will support you through the half.
And play Dota together.
And play Dota together.
Yeah. Okay, so you talk to her every day, but then ended up nothing proceeded from that. Mainly because you didn't initiate or what?
I think because I never initiated. I think last time I played beta.
And just the beta now. Am I wrong? Correct me if I'm wrong.
It depends on which headspace.
Okay, that's the secondary school, right? Then poly leh? No, like EC man. Like, never, I can't
even. Got EC.
Got EC. Then.
But the EC is the out of reach kind of EC.
What do you mean out of reach?
It's the every guy who see her will like her kind.
Okay, I understand. Yeah. I guess from what you are saying, it's also just not a priority for you at that point in time also?
At that point and now lah. Okay. I just started working, like proper working, like one, 2 years only, right?
I understand.
Yeah, so I think that's one thing I want to get straight first lah. And I think that I'm not at that level of financial stability yet. Because if you look at me, I'm 26, right? People who are younger than me probably just graduated from uni.
Mm.
And then probably not the most financially stable also to get married in like 5, 6, 7 years.
How about dating older girls then?
There are two ways to take this.
Why?
The first way is... the first way is the... Thank you. CCIE.
Oh!
On PS5.
My god! And then...
the second one is the... Yeah.
The what?
The dating just...
So the IE is what, your sugar mommy?
Older is fine, like I'm okay with older.
Okay.
It's just that me at this stage of life right now, it's not a priority for me though.
But I mean, from the way you say it, so it seems like you always think of it as like you are not able to provide or you are not able to like give like this amount of money because you just started work lah, you just did this and everything, right? Like, but you know, a relationship's like two together one, right?
Mm.
Like, have you not considered like that it's a together effort to reach the end goal? Then you can like think about it that way.
So when in the far future that kind of, of course it would be better if like two person come together, right?
Yes.
And then partner together and like work things out. And
why must it be far future? Why can't it be like 1 year and then you're on this side?
Because I don't think I'm happy with myself yet.
Okay, yeah. I understand.
And I don't want to bring someone into my arena of red flags just to sort out by myself lah. In whatever future there is lah, short or long lah, when two person come together.
Yeah.
The two person must match lah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you all know that I have a criteria when it comes to like, it's not a criteria and it's, okay, I don't want to sound overly prescriptive, okay? But this is what I look out for, okay?
Okay, say.
So I look out for chemistry.
Yes.
So very superficial things lah. Whether the person aesthetics might up my alley, if we can talk, if we laugh at the same thing. If I ask you how many kids does it take to paint the wall, your answer should be depends on how hard you throw them.
Okay. Like what is this aesthetic? Would you like to explain? So maybe some girl can slide in your DMs after this. I'm just helping you out, by the way.
How would you...
Okay, now I need to explain his aesthetic.
I
ask school student, look a bit like AG hipster one. Like to wear all black most of the time. Can be all dark colours. Got the moody vibe, like the don't touch me bitch, I will kill you from far. But actually she's like ooh inside one, that kind of thing. Must like anime, like die also like anime one. Then must watch same kind of anime that he like. Obviously must like cats because he likes cats, right? Yeah, and then don't need to like cats.
Okay.
Okay, animals. Need to be a bit like nerdy, but also very cool. You know what I mean? Like she look cool outside, but inside nerd and like sweet one. See?
Basically myself.
And like meme. He wants a girl version of himself basically. Which is like, how do I find? But okay.
Cannot find.
If you can find, right? Then like, it's like the, but I actually got one thing that I cannot. Then he will like, okay, bye. Right? Right? Am I wrong? I know him too well.
Yes,
I'm just exposing
him
on this episode.
Yes.
Yeah.
Actually it's all correct. Right? Like all the different. Okay, so that's just chemistry, right? But the scary thing is also that I can click with a lot of people.
Yes.
So that's why I need a second layer of filter.
Yes.
Second layer of filter is like the character of the person. I'm looking for someone who is daring, okay to do things. Basically looking for a very bro kind of girl.
Bro girl.
Yeah, that's character. I think that's one big thing that I look out for. Like,
okay.
What else?
Well, I think must be driven there.
Yeah, must be driven.
He's the kind, like you will tell me like if the person is not driven to like have a goal in life, right, then you will immediately turn off.
Yeah, if the person is noir. Lazy. Like every day wake up and then say, oh, I want to noir in bed at 12 o'clock. Then I do something. Then I'm like, oh, what are you doing in the afternoon? Don't know, I haven't think yet. Like, dude, do you not have a calendar? Do you not plan your days?
Do you
not plan your
calendar?
Week? Do you not plan what you want to do like in 1 month's time?
Okay.
So after chemistry and character, and the third one is what I want to call the core of their being.
Yeah.
What do they want to do with their life? And does it align with mine?
Mm.
Yeah. If they tell me that they want to travel the world like at 70, that kind, I'll tell them I will just be in a farm in northern Thailand looking at sakuras and playing with my cat.
Okay.
Yeah. So like that match already lah. And I think the core part is the most important part.
Yes.
Like if a person life goals doesn't align with mine. No matter how much you all come together and try to work things out, you all will still want to go to different places.
Yeah.
And that's terrifying in a 50-60 year relationship. That at the 30th year mark you realize that, hey, actually I want to live my life free and I don't want to be locked on my kids.
Yeah.
And then the other person said, oh actually, but we have a kid now.
Mm.
Then how? right? So
Now that you've shared a bit about your criteria or like expectations, right? Like, you know, when people hear this from you, right? Do people outside or maybe family, for example, what do they have to say about this?
I think my family, they are quite chill with me, because they know my stand towards this for quite some time already, so they are quite chill.
Okay.
And I think that I share this very similar thought process with my siblings also.
Okay.
Yeah, and then they are like, oh yeah, that makes sense, and okay, maybe we should do this with our lives instead of dating around, that kind of thing.
Mm. Well, an influencer just influences the entire family, like they're like, okay, I'm just not going to date anymore.
So but when I went to meet people outside,
they'll
tell me things like, oh man, you're wasting your youth. Like you're at a prime and you are like 20 plus only, just go and play, you're going to do all those things.
Yeah.
But then I always bring them back to the fact that if you want to do this, and whatever you do, you don't hurt other people, right?
Mm.
And if you hurt somebody else through this, it's very unfair. And I don't believe in causing unnecessary harm.
Wow, mental.
So that's what I tell my friends. I would just choose not to do it because of the potential repercussions that might come.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
What mature thinking. Most guys would be like, okay, I go and play.
You play, it's either you get hurt or somebody else get hurt, or then both get hurt.
I think a lot of times it's very temporary happiness in that sense, or temporary joys or needs being fulfilled. And I think I don't fault people who do that. I don't fault people who think your way also, because I think that it's just different priorities in life. So some people just really desire that need for someone in their life, and I think they are okay with the hurt that may happen after that. Like the pros of being in that relationship will overcome the hurt that happens in the future. But for you, it's the hurt will overcome everything, man.
Yeah. Okay. And I don't think emotional damage is that easy to get over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, you're very responsible.
I just try to...
Wow, it's still not very responsible, I feel. I never really meet these kind of people before in my life. I think the mentality of a lot of people is if anything go wrong, then too bad, go wrong. Because a lot of people go into relationships and then they don't expect it to last maybe forever, that kind of thing. Sometimes they know that it can be a both way thing. It can be very, very good in the long run, or it can not turn out very good in the long run. But they're willing to take the chance because they don't know where it's gonna go. Yeah, but they're prepared for both outcomes in that sense. Yeah, but I think for you, you're just if I don't even know which way it's gonna be, then I just don't want. Is that what you're trying to say also?
I just need more information before making my choices.
Oh my god. Okay, sir, I'll give you the time tasting menu, okay?
Tasting menu?
Speaking of tasting menu, how many dates have you been on?
How is that tasting menu?
You retaste the taste options available, right? Okay, wait, maybe I clarify first. Maybe I haven't dated before.
No, I just go out with people that...
You don't lie that you never date before.
I just go out. I just treat everyone okay, we are going out together. Just going out together.
Hello, Zula, first date, cough, cough.
Oh, okay. Then have Zula first
date. That one not date, man.
That work.
Fair. But still, it's still a date, okay?
Yes.
No, but
I go on a couple before, even for editorial side, they send me to
Okay, not work-related ones. The ones that you go willingly on your own. Yeah. Have what?
Have. So this people they are usually set up by friends or men, go, then okay, that sort of thing.
So most of the time the dates is your friends set you up?
Yeah, usually that. It's very easy to catch my eye. If you have very good aesthetics, right?
Ah,
and if my friend passed me your IG feed, and then I look at them, so if that happens, I'll be oh my goodness, okay, yeah. She'll be a cool person to get to know.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's mostly how it will go. We went to a ramen place, because I like ramen. And then yo, there's this ramen that you got to try, man.
You
got to try this. It's so good. And then turns out the person was like food lama, so it all worked out. After ramen, then sit at the ramen place, drink some highball, play phone game, talk about anime, talk about music. So a lot of things same. Listen same music and then talk maybe sometimes jinx that kind.
Damn.
I don't want to sound like everything was going well, that kind of, but chemistry was there, and then the character part fell through a bit.
Okay.
Yeah, because I realized that she was in a spot that she shouldn't be dating.
Okay.
But she still continued to do it.
I understand.
So I was like, oh my goodness, that's a...
oh my goodness, goodbye.
Yeah, I was like, oh.
Too bad.
I'm sorry. So my advice for that, for myself, then and now, is that go and meet people. Yeah, just go and meet people as a friend. Get to know them and through knowing them as a friend, right, with no commitment, it will help you to make better judgment calls.
I understand.
I think that's one big thing that I learned, that when you meet people, right, whether you call it a date or not, or you're just going out with your friends, like secondary school friends, both of you still single at the time.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a very good time and it's a very good opportunity for you to just get to know someone as a person and not as a potential partner.
I guess one question then, right, is that do you have this fear of like commitment? I mean, to be very honest lah, you know, because of a lot of things that you mentioned, it kind of leads me in that direction to want to know if this is something that you are scared of.
Okay, a lot of people ask me this before. Okay, they ask me, are you afraid of commitment? One thing, then the other thing is like, as much as you don't want to hurt the person, is it because you don't want to be hurt?
Oh, this is saucy, yeah, right? Saucy, yeah, right? Definitely what something.
Okay, answer the first one first, okay? I'm not afraid of commitment.
Yeah.
It's just I'm afraid of committing to the wrong person.
Okay, understand. Yeah. Understand. So the next one is, are you afraid of being hurt?
Okay,
why? Because the way you say, yes, it's like, I don't want to hurt people, I don't want to hurt people. But then, the real question is, Mandon, do you want to be hurt?
I don't nobody wants to be hurt.
No, but... Okay, fair, nobody wants to be hurt.
I think I'm more afraid of hurting other people than me myself getting hurt. Because really? I know that I am... not flex or what, but I know that I'm self-aware enough.
Okay.
And I am emotionally stable enough to not go haywire. And
right.
So, okay. I'm more afraid of hurting other people than myself getting hurt. As to like why, when I go with people, right, it didn't progress to like a full relationship, right?
Yeah.
When... How do I put it? Okay, it's similar to the criteria thing that I shared just now.
Yes.
But it is more like when what and the other party wants out of this friendship, going out together, shit, is different from what I want. What I want is I want to get to know you as a friend, and I want to know you as a person first, before anything else.
Yeah.
But then if a person wants to like leap 10 steps, you want the meme, the like climb 10 steps.
What is leaping 10 steps?
The leap 10 steps.
I know the meme, but what?
Yeah, if basically if the person...
I'm like the no, Mandon. Or they want to be like intimate.
If they want intimacy without a commitment,
that's a no.
Yeah.
Okay, understand. So then, Mandon, do you believe in marriage?
Marriage. For me, I believe in marriage as an institution. Like it is. Marriage is good, lah. Marriage is a thing. Marriage is as much as being celibate and being single is a gift in itself, right? Marriage is also a gift.
Okay, fair. Yeah, do you believe in it?
Yes.
Do you believe
I believe in marriage.
Will you want to get married in the future?
As of now, no. If I grow older and I realize that I need to get married. And like the
single
life is
not for me. What do you need to get married?
No, maybe not need, like companionship.
Okay.
Kind of, like if I realize that, I actually have this need to share my life with somebody.
Okay.
Then I would get married.
Okay, but as of now you feel like you don't need to share that with anybody.
I don't care.
Your cat cannot respond to you, bro.
Oh, he give me high fives.
Your cat can high five you. Can your cat talk besides meow? Slap it! I want to get slapped, you know, Mandon. Oh my god. So from what you're saying, it's kind of like, I don't feel like I want to be in a relationship or get married, but if this one unicorn person comes along from the people that I meet, I'm like, okay, I gotta marry you.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus! He's waiting for the one to drop from the sky. Like, this is literally what you're saying.
Hey, as much as I'm like waiting for the one to come and drop from the sky, I'm constantly trying to be like the one for like that one. So
if next time you really find a good person, I'll be like the person at the wedding to say the speech for you. I'll be like, you know how many years you've taken Mandon? It took one whole video of me trying to ask him to explain his criteria before he found you. Just saying.
It took two work articles and
one Zula first dates. Oh my god. Help Mandon find a girlfriend. Should we make it a series? Help Mandon find a girlfriend. Then Mandon just go on dates with like multiple girls until the one drops from the sky.
Oh.
Comment in the comments down below.
Here actually, being single in Singapore, like I was talking about housing and all.
Yeah.
It's very unfair.
I agree.
It's very, very unfair.
We legit just made a video about this, like on Chick Chats, talking about like the BTO and like housing culture in Singapore and how like
insane.
You literally need to be in a relationship to live by yourself in Singapore.
It's mad, unless you are balling and you can just buy a...
Most people are not balling.
Yeah, if you can rough the back, get a private property.
Yeah.
And then you just stay there. Sure, why not? But
yeah.
Yo, honestly, being single in Singapore is not the easiest thing.
Yeah.
There are a lot of grants that you can't take.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, even if I want to get a house next time, right? I cannot get the the family grants. And that's like free, 60-70k. Like,
yeah.
That's a huge offset to your housing loan.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you, if you follow the Singaporean dream,
yes.
You go to local U, get a local U cert, work in government.
Or like even marriage is part of the Singaporean dream.
Yeah,
it
is.
Right?
So like, I think it's a prereq to like get all those things, all the good job, good education, and then good marriage, then get a good house, then you can live in Singapore.
And then you have two children, one boy, one girl.
Singaporean dream is very unfair to people who choose to be single or people who just subscribe
to the Singaporean dream.
Yeah, basically.
I mean, there's many different aspects of that Singaporean dream,
yeah,
right? But like, getting basic things like housing is something that is already very hard to achieve. Yeah, but I mean, I know of people who have, I mean, like, who have obviously gotten a house at 35 and everything, are living very successful lives. But it's just that when you're young, like, our age, I don't think we're very young, but as in like younger, our age, they oftentimes it's very, you feel very scared, right? Like you don't know what is ahead also.
Yeah. Like you can't predict that.
Correct. And then when you get into a relationship, you know what to expect. You know what I mean? Because you know like, okay, I'm gonna get married, I'm gonna get BTO or resale, and then like at least I buy a house. You know, like you can at least predict that direction that you're going in. But when you choose to, for example, stay single, it's like you don't know how it's gonna go also, right? Yeah.
That's why you gotta make plans for yourself.
Yeah.
And I think that it goes back to the whole thing about being your own person.
Yeah.
And if you cannot make plans for yourself, then you are not even suited to be in a relationship. Because you can't even you can't even handle yourself.
Yeah.
Why not another person's life then?
Okay, maybe for you, Mandon, your choice is to kind of stay single. For example, you're still working on yourself, etc. But for people who are not necessarily single by choice but haven't really dated, are also like in this evergreen status at like a later age in life, is there any advice you can give to them, or is there anything that you can share to your, based on your own experiences?
It is very, very important to know, number one, what you want. And if it's a relationship that you want, right, then pull all stops. Your friends, go on apps, go to a bar and dress up nicely and talk to people, whatever floats your boat, right? Both a relationship and being single is a gift. Being single, right, like for me right now, I think I have the headspace and I have the brain capacity to do things that I don't have to consider or like sharing with anybody else. You have a lot of space to do what you want to do with your life.
Like, I think my own advice, right, because I think I've seen my friends who are the kind of people who really depend on relationships, like, every time they get out of a relationship, they're like, oh shit, something is missing from my life. I need like a person, I need like someone to fill this void in my life. Which, to be very honest, I think is a bit unhealthy. Because if you're constantly looking for someone to fill this void in your life, then you're not actually focusing on yourself. You're devoting your life to someone else in that sense. Which is like, I don't know whether that's fulfilling for you, but I feel that actually you can find your own sense of self-fulfillment in doing things that you like.
Nobody can take whole of how you live your life except yourself. If you want to live your life chasing your hobbies and becoming the person that you can be, right, or like the best version of yourself, right, only you can do it for yourself.
True.
Don't rely on other people to fill your own need.
Wow, great words of advice. Well, I think we can end the video here. Thank you, Mandon, for your sharing your own stories but also giving a lot of very useful advice to people who are in relationships and to people who are also single.
Oh my god, what if like this video break people up? They realize that, oh my god, I'm in a relationship and but because I want people to fulfill my needs, then I want to be in a relationship. I don't think I should be in a relationship, let's break up.
Okay, take everything with a pinch of salt, guys. Okay, this is not, Mandon is not the love guru of the world. He's just applying whatever his own principles are to how he views relationships. I think there's many different tips that people can take away, different types of people can take away from this video lah. Yeah, and also I guess the juicy gossip that y'all wanted is to why Mandon is single, here's the real reason. Honestly, it's not that juicy.
It's not that juicy.
It's damn fucking practical.
It's
like I feel like I listened to like a freaking, a lecturer explaining to me about how
to have a successful relationship.
This is how you have a successful relationship. The entire video is like, this is how you have a successful relationship. Whether or not it's true is another story, but you can take away some things from this. If not, then like, I hope you enjoyed the video anyway. If you like this video, let us know who else you want us to interview on this segment of Ask ZULA. And yeah, leave in the comments down below. And also don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye.
Bye.